Hello friends, this is Praveen. Welcome to our YouTube channel. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss the vector product or cross product of the two vectors. Previously, we have discussed that there are three ways that a vector can be multiplied. The number one is scalar multiplication. In scalar multiplication, a vector can be multiplied by a scalar to get resultant as a vector. For example, here mass is a scalar quantity and A is acceleration, which is a vector quantity. If mass is multiplied by acceleration, then resultant is a vector, which is force. So this is what scalar multiplication, in which resultant is a vector quantity. The second way to multiply a vector is what vector multiplication by another vector to get resultant as a scalar quantity. This is also called as dot product of the two vectors. So in scalar product, a vector is multiplied by another vector and resultant is a scalar quantity. For example, here force is a vector quantity and displacement is also a vector quantity. And when they are multiplied with each other, then resultant is a scalar quantity, which is called work done. Here dot sign is used for the scalar product. That is why it is also called as dot product. The way number third is a vector can be multiplied by another vector to get resultant as a vector quantity. Here, R vector is called as moment arm, which is also a vector quantity, and force is a vector quantity. If both are multiplied by with each other, then resultant is obtained as a vector quantity, which is called as moment of force or torque vector. Here, cross sign is used for the vector product. That is why vector product is also called as cross product. We have already discussed these two methods, that is scalar multiplication and scalar product of the two vectors. Now in today's lecture, we are going to focus on the third way to multiply the two vectors, which is called as vector product. So let us define what is vector product or cross product. So what is vector product or cross product? Here we have the definition. The vector product or cross product of the two vectors, vector A and vector B, is another vector, vector R, whose magnitude is equal to the product of the magnitude of the two vectors and sine of the smaller angle between them. Suppose I have the two vectors vector A and vector B joined tail to tail, and if I need to find the vector A cross vector B, then it is equal to another vector, vector R, whose magnitude is equal to the product of the magnitude of vector A and vector B and sine of the smaller angle theta between them. Let's define it again. The vector product or cross product of the two vectors, vector A and vector B, is another vector, vector R, whose magnitude is equal to the product of the magnitude of the two vectors and sine of the smaller angle between them. It is represented by A vector cross B vector. Here cross sign is used for vector multiplication. That is why the vector product is also called as cross product. If theta be the smaller angle between vector A and vector B, then magnitude of A vector cross B vector, that is mod of A vector cross B vector, is equal to mod of R vector, and this is equal to mod of A vector into mod of B vector and sine of theta, where theta is smaller angle, which is greater than or equals to 0 degree and less than or equals to 180 degree. Therefore, in vector form, I can write here A vector cross B vector is equal to R vector, which is equal to mod of A vector into mod of B vector sine of theta. See, right hand side is a scalar. Therefore, I need to multiply a unit vector in order to give it a resultant vector. So I will multiply it by a unit vector, which is n cap. What is n cap? N cap is a unit vector which is directed along R vector. So I can say that n cap is unit vector of vector R. From this formula, I can also write here vector A cross vector B is equal to, this value is what? It is mod of vector A cross vector B. Therefore, I can write here mod of A vector cross B vector at the place of mod of A vector into mod of B vector sine of theta into n cap. Therefore, if I need to find the n cap, then n cap can be written as A vector cross B vector divided by mod of A vector cross B vector. Now, direction of A vector cross B vector is perpendicular to the plane containing A vector and B vector. That is, R vector will always be perpendicular to the plane in which A vector and B vector are represented, and the direction is given by right hand thumb rule or right handed screw rule. Both rules can be applied in order to obtain the direction of A vector cross B vector or resultant R vector. Now, to find the direction of A vector cross B vector, we can either use the right hand thumb rule or right handed screw rule. Here I am going to describe about the right hand thumb rule. What is right hand thumb rule? According to this rule, if we curl the fingers of the right hand, keeping the thumb erect in such a way that the fingers point in the direction of rotation from vector A to vector B through the smaller angle, then the thumb points in the direction of A vector cross B vector. Suppose I have taken the two vectors, vector A and vector B, connected tail to tail in the plane of this whiteboard. I have to find the direction of A vector cross B vector. For that, I will use the right hand thumb rule. I will place the fingers of the right hand along the direction of vector A with this thumb outstretched or erected, that is perpendicular to these four fingers. If I curl these four fingers in a direction from A to B vector through the smaller angle theta, then the direction in which the thumb is pointing will give the direction of A vector cross B vector. So in this case, to find the A vector cross B vector, I am rotating these curled fingers from A vector to B vector in anti-clockwise direction. Therefore, the thumb is pointing perpendicular to the plane of the whiteboard directed outside. That is, the direction of A vector cross B vector will be perpendicular to the plane of this whiteboard directed outside. So for a vector pointing outside and perpendicular to the plane is represented by dotted circle. Therefore, R vector is equal to A vector cross B vector will be perpendicular to the plane of this whiteboard in which vector A and vector B are represented or given. Now, we can use the same rule, that is right hand thumb rule, to find B vector cross A vector. For this, I will place these four fingers along the direction of B vector with the thumb outstretched. If I rotate these four fingers, or if I curl these four fingers in the direction of rotation from vector B to vector A through the smaller angle, then this outstretched thumb or this erected thumb will give the direction of R vector. In this case, when I rotate these curled fingers from B vector to A vector, then thumb points perpendicular to the plane of the whiteboard pointing inside the board. That is, direction of B vector cross A vector will be perpendicular to the plane of the whiteboard directed inside. So the direction of B vector cross A vector is perpendicular to the plane of the whiteboard directed inside of the plane. Therefore, the direction of B vector cross A vector and A vector cross B vector is not same, even though both have the same magnitude. What is the magnitude of B vector cross A vector? It is mod of B vector into mod of A vector sine of theta, but direction of unit vector n cap will be opposite. That is why I have taken minus sign here, but magnitude part will be same in both cases. Here it will be A mod of A vector into mod of B vector sine of theta into n cap, and here I have taken minus n cap. Why? Because R vector is directed in opposite side. Here R vector is pointing outside of the plane, and here R vector, that is B vector cross A vector, is pointing inside the plane. That is why I have taken minus R vector equals to B vector cross A vector, and here I have taken R vector is equal to A vector cross B vector. for a vector pointing inside the plane and perpendicular to the plane is represented by circle crossed, and for a vector perpendicular to the plane directed outside is represented by circle dotted. So in this way I can represent the direction of A vector cross B vector or B vector cross A vector, and from these two diagrams I can say that A vector cross B vector is not equal to B vector cross A vector, even though both have the same magnitude. That is, I can write here A vector cross B vector is equal to minus B vector cross A vector. Alright, similarly I can use right handed screw rule to find the direction of A vector cross B vector or B vector cross A vector. A vector cross B vector will have its direction perpendicular to the plane of the whiteboard directed outside, and the direction of B vector cross A vector will have its direction perpendicular to the plane of the whiteboard directed inside the plane. Alright, okay, now let's discuss the different cases of the cross product. Number one, if A vector and B vector are parallel or anti-parallel, that is theta is equal to 0 or 180 degree, then sine theta will be equal to 0. Therefore, A vector cross B vector will represent 0 vector and its magnitude will be equal to 0, because sine 0 or sine 180 is equal to 0. Therefore, if I take the cross product of two same type of unit vectors, that is I cap cross I cap or J cap cross J cap or K cap cross K cap, then all values will be equal to 0 cap, and if I take the magnitude of all cross product, then they will be equal to 0. In dot product, if I take the dot product of same type of unit vector, then it is equal to 1. But in cross product, the cross product of two same type of unit vectors is always equal to 0, whether I take I cap cross I cap or J cap cross J cap or K cap cross K cap. Now in case number 2, if A vector and B vector are perpendicular, that is theta is equal to 90 degree, then sine theta is equal to 1. Therefore, A vector cross B vector is equal to mod of A vector into mod of B vector n cap, where n cap is perpendicular to the plane of A vector and B vector, and its mod is equal to mod of A vector into mod of B vector. That is the magnitude of the cross product when they are perpendicular to each other is equal to the product of the magnitude of A vector and magnitude of B vector, or mod of A vector and mod of B vector. Now if I take the cross product of orthogonal unit vectors, suppose I cap, J cap and K cap be the orthogonal unit vectors along X axis, Y axis and Z axis, and if I am taking the cross product in anti-clockwise direction, here I can see if I am taking the cross product between the two vectors which are perpendicular, then resultant is a vector perpendicular to the plane containing A vector and B vector. Therefore, if I take the cross product between I cap and J cap, then I will get resultant as a unit vector perpendicular to the plane of I cap and J cap. What is the plane of I cap and J cap? It is XY plane, and the vector which is perpendicular to XY is what? It is Z axis or Z vector, and its unit vector is what? It is K cap. Therefore, I cap cross J cap is equal to what? It is K cap. So if I am taking the cross product between the orthogonal unit vectors rotating in anti-clockwise direction, then I will get the third unit vector which is always positive. So I cap cross J cap is equal to K cap. I cap cross J cap is equal to K cap, because I am taking the cross product in a direction in anti-clockwise direction. Therefore, I will get the third unit vector which is always positive. Similarly, if I take J cap cross K cap, then I will get I cap which is positive. J cap cross K cap is equal to I cap. And similarly, if I take K cap cross I cap, K cap cross I cap, then I will get the third unit vector which is perpendicular to both K cap and I cap, and its value will be positive. Now if I'm taking the cross product between the two unit vectors in clockwise direction, then I will get the third unit vector which is always negative. For example, If I am taking j cap cross k cap, then I will get the third unit vector which is perpendicular to both j cap and I cap, but its sign will be always negative. So j cap cross I cap will be minus k cap, and k cap cross j cap will be minus I cap, and I cap cross k cap will be minus j cap. So if I am taking the cross product of two orthogonal unit vectors in anti-clockwise direction, then I will get the third unit vector which is always positive. And if I am taking the cross product between two orthogonal unit vectors in clockwise direction, then I will get the third unit vector which is perpendicular to both and whose value is always negative. So this is what: j cap cross I cap is minus k cap cross j cap is equal to minus I cap, and I cap cross k cap is equal to minus j cap. Now friends, let's discuss the cross product in component form. Suppose I have two vectors, vector A and vector B, given in terms of their three dimensional rectangular components. That is, vector A equals to AX I cap plus AY j cap plus AZ k cap, and vector B equals to BX I cap plus BY j cap plus BZ k cap. And I need to find A vector cross B vector. Therefore, A vector cross B vector will be in first bracket AX I cap plus AY j cap plus AZ k cap, cross in second bracket BX I cap plus BY j cap plus BZ k cap. And this is equal to what? Cross product of this first term with this bracket, that is AX I cap cross this bracket, plus cross product of the second term in first bracket with the second bracket, plus cross product of the third term in first bracket with the second bracket. And if I simplify all the brackets, then I get what? AX BX I cap cross I cap, because these are scalar, so cross product will be taken between unit vectors, plus AX BY I cap cross J cap plus AZ BZ I cap cross K cap. Now I will simplify the second bracket. So AY BX in bracket J cap cross K cap plus AY BY in bracket J cap cross J cap plus AY BZ in bracket J cap cross K cap plus, I will simplify the third one. So it is what? AZ BX in bracket k cap cross I cap plus AZ BY in bracket k cap cross j cap plus AZ BZ in bracket k cap cross k cap. Now, as we have discussed earlier, that the cross product of same type of unit vectors is always equal to zero. So the cross product containing I cap cross I cap, J cap cross J cap and K cap cross K cap will be zero. So these three terms will be equal to zero. Now remaining will be simplified as, this is equal to AX BY and I cap cross J cap will be K cap. I cap cross J cap will be K cap because I am moving in anti-clockwise direction. Plus, what is the second term? It is AX BZ. AX BZ I cap cross k cap, I cap cross k cap in clockwise, so it will be negative j cap. Plus what is the third term? AYBX and j cap, AYBX j cap cross I cap, so j cap cross I cap in clockwise, it will be minus k cap. Plus next term is what? AYBZ j cap cross k cap, j cap cross k cap, it is in anti-clockwise, so I will get what? I cap plus I cap. Plus next term is what? It is AZBX k cap cross I cap, k cap cross I cap, so it will be plus j cap. So here it is plus j cap. Plus last term is what? AZBY k cap cross j cap, k cap cross j cap, so it will be negative I cap. Now if I simplify it again, then I will get what? I will get, first of all, I will write the terms containing I cap. So it is AYBZ plus AZBX plus I cap minus minus AY BZ, sorry, AZ BY I cap, because here there is minus sign, so plus minus will be minus. So I can write here minus AZ BY I cap. Now I will write what? I will write the terms containing unit vector J cap. So this is first term, and this is this is the first term which contains J cap, and this is second term. So first of all, I will write the positive term, which is AZ BX J cap. So AZ BX J cap, then I will write this is plus minus will be minus. If I multiply this plus sign with this minus sign, then it will be minus sign. So this term will be negative AX BZ J cap. Now I will write the terms containing a unit vector k cap. So this is first term, which is positive ax by k cap, and what is the next term? This is negative term, plus minus will be minus, plus into minus will be minus. So I can write here ay bx k cap. Now I can take the I cap common, so I get in bracket what? Ay bz minus az by outside I cap. And if I take J cap common, then I get in bracket AZ BX minus AX BZ, plus if I take K cap common, then I get in bracket AX BY minus AY BX. This is equal to what? This is equal to A cap cross B cap. A vector cross B vector. But it is difficult to memorize this formula. Therefore, this value can also be written in terms of the determinants. This is equal to what? A vector cross B vector. This value, same value, can be written as in determinant I cap, J cap, K cap. Since we need to find A vector cross B vector, therefore I will write first of all the coefficients of I cap, J cap, K cap of vector A, AX, AY, AZ. And then I will write the coefficients of I cap, K, J cap, and K cap of the vector B, BX, BY, BZ. So in component form, A vector cross B vector is equal to determinant I cap, J cap, K cap, AX, BY, AX, AY, AZ. And in third row, BX, BY, BZ. Similarly, if I need to find B vector cross A vector, then it is equal to what? Determinant I cap, J cap, K cap. And first of all, I will write the coefficients of I cap, J cap, K cap of vector B. Therefore, it is BX, BY, BZ, and AX, AY, AZ. See how to find the coefficient of I cap, J cap, K cap using determinant. I need to find the coefficient of I cap, then I will hide this column and I will cross multiply these values, AY BZ minus AZ BY. Then I will get the first bracket. If I need to find the second bracket, that is coefficient of J cap, then I will hide the second column and I will cross multiply these terms. But in this case, I will multiply first of all AZ BX, AZ BX, and then I will multiply AX BZ. And if I need to find the coefficient of K cap, then I will hide the third column and I will cross multiply in the way as I have done for the first bracket, that is AX BY and AY BZ. In this way, I can calculate A vector cross B vector. All right. So this is the cross product of A vector and B vector in component form, which is equal to determinant I cap, J cap, K cap, AX, AY, AZ, and BX, BY, BZ. Now let's discuss what are the properties of the cross product. So first one, cross product obeys anti-commutative law. Anti-commutative law. That is, cross product of two vectors does not obey commutative law. It is unlike dot product. In dot product of the two vectors obey the commutative law, but cross product of the two vectors does not obey the commutative law, because A vector cross B vector is equal to mod of A vector into mod of B vector sine of theta n cap and B vector cross A vector is equal to mod of A vector into mod of B vector sine theta minus n cap, that is equal to minus mod of A vector into mod of B vector sine theta n cap, and this is equal to what? This is minus, and this value is what? A vector cross B vector. Therefore, B vector cross A vector is equal to minus A vector cross B vector, or B vector cross A vector is not equal to A vector cross B vector. Therefore, cross product does not obey commutative law, it obeys anti-commutative law. Number two, it obeys distributive law. That is, A vector cross B vector plus C vector. B vector plus C vector. Cross product of the two vectors obeys distributive law. That is, A vector cross B vector plus C vector. This is first vector, this is second vector. And if I take the cross product of A vector with B vector plus C vector, which is supposed to be a single vector, then it is equal to what? A vector cross B vector plus A vector cross C vector. Third one, cross product obeys associative law. It obeys associative law. That is, A vector plus B vector cross C vector plus D vector is equal to A vector cross C vector plus A vector cross D vector plus B vector cross C vector plus B vector cross D vector. These are the properties of the cross product. Cross product obeys anti-commutative law, that is, it does not obey commutative law. Second one is, it obeys distributive law. And third one, it obeys associative law. These are the three properties of the cross product. Now let's discuss what is the geometrical meaning of the cross product. Suppose I have taken the two vectors, vector A and vector B, along the two adjacent sides of a parallelogram having smaller angle theta between them. So if I complete the parallelogram with the sides OP, PR, RQ and QO, and if I drop the perpendicular from point Q on vector A, suppose the height is h, so this height h represents the height of the parallelogram. So let us find the area of this parallelogram. So area of parallelogram is what? Area of parallelogram is equal to base into height. Base into height. So this is equal to what? What is base? It is mod of A vector into height is what? It is h. Now we need to find this height h. So I can use the formula of right angle triangle. So this is a right angle triangle, this is hypotenuse and this is opposite side. So I can take the sine theta, and sine theta is equal to what? Opposite side, which is h upon hypotenuse, which is mod of B vector. Therefore h is equal to what? Mod of B vector into sine theta. So if I substitute the value of h in this formula, then I get what? Mod of A vector into mod of B vector sine theta. And this is what? Area of parallelogram. And this value is what? This is nothing but mod of A vector cross B vector. Therefore, if two vectors are represented along the two sides of a parallelogram having smaller angle theta, then the mod of A vector cross B vector will represent the area of the parallelogram. This is the geometrical meaning of the cross product. What I said? If two vectors are taken along the two adjacent sides of a parallelogram with smaller angle theta, then the mod of A vector cross B vector, that is magnitude of A vector cross B vector, will represent the area of the parallelogram. This is the geometrical meaning of the cross product. Similarly, if we have given the two vectors, vector A and vector B, along the two sides of a triangle, then A vector, mod of A vector cross B vector, is equal to the twice of the area of the triangle. And what will be the area of triangle? It is, area of triangle is half into mod of A vector cross B vector. That is, I will get what? I will get twice into, what is area of triangle? It is 1 by 2 mod of A vector into mod of B vector sine of theta. This will be area of the triangle. This is area of triangle, and A vector mod of A vector into B cross B vector is equal to twice of this value. Alright, so in order to find the area of the triangle, I can use the formula half into mod of A vector cross B vector. So this formula will give the area of the triangle, and for the parallelogram, I can directly find out the mod of A vector cross B vector. So this will give the area of the parallelogram. That's all. So friends, that's all for today. In next lecture, we are going to solve the numericals based on the cross product. Thanks for watching my videos. Bye bye.